tournament.
Thank you, baby. Hey, if you love the King of Rock and Roll, and who doesn't love the King of Rock and Roll? Elvis fans, what a treat. We welcome in Kevin Kern. He is from Graceland, the Director of Communications. We are talking about Elvis Presley Aloha from Hawaii 40th anniversary celebration. And my friend, I have you in here, Kevin. We've got to start with,
yes.
Would you say this is the most famous cape in the history of the world?
The most famous. Of course, there's a Superman cape, but there's it doesn't get any more famous than Elvis Presley.
Oh, yeah,
and
baby.
This is what he wore 40 years ago, January 14th, at the Blaisdell for the Aloha from Hawaii concert. Live in 40 nations, more people saw Elvis in concert than man landing on the moon, believe
it or not. Man, that is absolutely neat. How this came about? Because this is now in the hands of Graceland.
This is in the hands of Graceland. Elvis wore this in the actual concert. He threw it into the audience following the concert, and a reporter actually caught it, then sold it to a fan, and then that fan willed it back to the estate following his death. But, of course, all of this is here as we celebrate the 40th anniversary of this event with a one-night-only monumental music event at the Blaze.
This coming Monday
at 7:30 p.m. Tickets available at the box office and through Ticketmaster.
Well, we've got other stuff here. Yes. This is a pendant. What's the significance of the pendant?
Significance of the pendant is that the Kuili Cancer Foundation was the beneficiary of the concert and all of the proceeds from that concert in 1973. So they presented this with Elvis with diamonds, and of course his name is etched into the pendant, and he was provided that during the rehearsal, and he actually wore it during the actual broadcast.
That's one thing. Obviously the music was amazing, but he cared greatly about people. He was a huge philanthropist, and that's part of what we have over here as well.
And of course, Elvis's love affair started with Hawaii when he came to visit. He filmed three movies here, but also he did a fundraiser for the USS Arizona Memorial. Kind of fundraising had stalled. He came and did a concert at the Block Arena, and of course, that is where the true love affair with Elvis Presley in Hawaii started. And just a great person, and this state meant so much to him. And we're so glad to be back and celebrating it with all of our friends here in Hawaii.
And for folks who don't know, like as you said, he filmed a number of movies over
here.
He loved here. I mean, it was a definite love affair.
It did. Elvis came here to work. He came here to fundraise. But back then and still today, the Presley family still vacations and enjoys time here in Hawaii.
There's a website that folks can go to if they want to find out all the different things that are happening. Obviously, Monday night is the big event,
elvis.com/aloha. We also have a free photo exhibit at the USS Arizona Memorial and Pearl Harbor Visitor Center on Saturday and Sunday from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m., so come check it out.
It's the most visited tourist attraction is the USS Arizona in Hawaii, and it would not have been built if not for
Elvis came in and did this fundraising concert and truly helped put it over the top and make it possible, and after it was completed, he came back and had a very solemn experience there. And of course, Elvis was a member of the U.S. Army, so he knew what it meant to serve.
Kevin,
thank you.
Thank you very much. Again, the website is www.elvis.com/aloha.
Y'all come see.
All right. Wake Up Today is going to continue. We got a very special birthday celebration that we want to tell you about. And of course, you can't go wrong. I mean, it's the King's Cape. All right. Stay with us right here on Wake Up Today.